Guakship, that way. Everest Base Camp, that way.
Alright guys, it's about 10 PM now and we have just arrived in Kathmandu. So right now we are just gonna head to our hotel, rest for a few hours and start our journey tomorrow at 4 AM.
Tiring, but at the same time, that is the more sure option I can propose you at the
Okay.
Good morning guys, so today is the first day of our entire trip. And right now we are at the local airport where we will take the flight to Lukla. And then from Lukla, we'll start the entire trek up to Everest Base Camp. Last night, our guide actually told us a lot of these planes can't fly out because of the bad weather. A lot of the travelers over here actually are stuck for 3 days already. Hopefully, you can catch a flight out to Lukla. Okay, guys. The news just came in. We don't have any flights to Lukla today. So, we're gonna take a 10-hour drive to...
10-hour with y'all.
Somewhere, rest for maybe 6-7 hours and then tomorrow morning we're gonna take a off-road drive to Lukla. Then we'll officially start our hike tomorrow.
Lukla is over there.
Yeah.
We couldn't climb over there.
I see, okay.
We can go all the way down.
Okay. Yeah.
To Hagding is here.
Day 2, good morning. Namaste.
Namaste.
Namaste, let's go.
Let's go.
We're gonna start our 6 hours drive up to Lukla area.
As long as you love me, who you are, where you're from.
Hey! Alright guys, this is the starting point and we're gonna hike about 4 hours up to Phat Lu where we'll rest the night and head to Phat Ding and Nam Che Bazaar tomorrow. Good morning guys, it's day 3 of the hike and we are granted with a really awesome view right outside our hotel. After about 2 hours, we are now here at Phat Ding. So we have about 5 hours more to Nam Che Bazaar. Just meet.
Wow, freaking show.
Nice, we are at Nam Che Bazaar now. This is the entrance where we'll be staying for tonight. And this is like a city high up on the mountains. It has really a nice view over here. Alright, tonight we are staying here at Hotel Tibet. Having Shin Ramen for dinner. What a comfort food. Starting day 4 with a good breakfast. Today is actually an acclimatization day. Okay, sounds good. So it's supposed to be a 1 hour hike up to the top. Alright, we are reaching the Everest View Hotel and this is our first view of Everest. Nice. Okay, we are done with the Okay, we're acclimatization hike. And now we are gonna tour around this city and then stock on some stuff.
Like, we
need to buy some sweater and hiking sticks. So we're just gonna chill around today. Day 5 of the hike. So today will be an ascent up to Tembuche, and then we'll stay at Pangbuche. It's gonna be a 7-hour hike, right?
Today.
Okay. Oh. Hopefully we make it in 7 hours. Nothing more than that. So we need to go all the way down to the river, cross the river, and then we're gonna have lunch there before you hit up. Alright, we are having a quick lunch before we spend another 4 hours going up the mountain. Just look at the view. We are feeling good so far. Right now we are at Tembuche, and we are about 20 minutes away from our accommodation between Tembuche and Pangbuche. So we're gonna just push on. So far it's been really manageable because we have been keeping our heart rate about zone 2.
Poi! Poi!
Alright, day 6. Look at our breakfast. Rosti with egg, mustard, and cheese.
Thank you. So can we order one more?
Good morning guys, today is day 6 and we are heading to Tembuche, which is about 4,410 meters high in altitude. As you can see, we have our porters behind. Utmost respect to them because they are carrying really a lot of heavy weights. Alright, we passed by Pangbuche. So we are at 3,900 meters in altitude now. So far the slopes have been very gentle, which makes it a very good hike. We have 4 more hours to go. Hey guys, finally we are at Tembuche. And as you can see, it's currently snowing a little bit. Alright, this is our room in Tembuche, and it's actually quite comfortable. Look at our bed here, warm blankets, and apparently Tiala is below, so we're gonna make some noise. Morning guys, it's day 7. Today is our acclimatization day at Tembuche, and just look at the view. So we are staying around there last night, so there's one more night before we head to Tembuche. Alright, we are done with our acclimatization hike. We are now at around 4,800 meters in altitude. So now we're just gonna head back down and then chill at the cafe. It's day 8 and we are en route to Tembuche from Tembuche. It'll be about a 4 to 5 hours trek. Alright, the uphill is done. Now we are going slightly downhill. Throughout the video, you'll probably see more downhills because during the uphills, you're probably too tired to film anything. So this is the memorial place where they pay tributes to hikers who have unfortunately lost their lives while attempting to summit Mount Everest. So this is how the place looks like. And this is the famous hiker Scott Fisher, who have summited Mount Everest and also other highest mountains around the world. We are at somewhere past Lovoce now. We are at about 5,000 meters in altitude. And as we are reaching our accommodation, it started snowing quite heavily, I would say. So quite a new experience for us. And this is our accommodation for the night. Morning guys, today is day 9. The official day that we'll be heading to Everest Base Camp. And this is where we stayed last night. We are about 4 to 5 hours away. And we are only 2 minutes in and I'm already quite breathless because of the tea net. Alright, we have reached our ship. And now we are on the way to Everest Base Camp.
Guakship that way, or Everest Base Camp that way, or license and registration. Come.
Don't have.
You grab ke belakang busik.
Meters. Everest Base Camp.
Today I would like to announce that we will not go to Chola Pass. Today after 8 hours head to EBC, we'll be taking a choice back to Noche Bazaar and back to Lukla and back to Kathmandu. We made this decision together as a team and that is what matters most, right?
Alright, good morning guys. It's day 10. And today we are officially descending down to Namche Bazaar, so it will be a 10 hour hike. Huge thanks to Hari, our guide, pacer, dancer, and also entertainer for the trip. And of course, our dear porters, who we have so much respect for. See you guys on the next trip.